Dear users, you may have many queries or doubts about filling of student data capture format. Now we are here with a solution to all your queries and doubts. Just plug into our FAQ videos and get the solution on the spot. FAQ video is available on website student.udice.in.
So please tell us something about student data collection process.
Who will manage the student data at the national level? Can I get the list of students from the student portal? What is the use of collecting student-wise data? We were collecting similar kind of data in our state. Do we have to collect the data again?
Can you please tell me about the calendar of activities for implementing SDMIS? Who will verify the student data if the data is entered at school level? What will we do if we require some help about filling the student DCM?
रूपा ने और मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय ने अब ये निर्णय लिया है कि 2016-17 वर्ष से अब हम स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इकट्ठा करेंगे ताकि हम यूडाइस की सभी एनरोलमेंट की टेबल्स हैं उसको स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इकट्ठा करके जनरेट करवा दें। इससे हमें ये मदद मिलेगी अगर कहीं पर डुप्लीकेट एनरोलमेंट है बच्चे हैं या ओवर एनरोलमेंट है ओवर रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ एनरोलमेंट है या कहीं कहीं अगर फेक एनरोलमेंट भी है तो उन सबको चेक करने का हम प्रयास करेंगे और हमें पूरा उम्मीद है कि ऐसा करने से हमारे स्टूडेंट हमारे नामांकन की हमारे एनरोलमेंट की गुणवत्ता क्वालिटी और अच्छी बेहतर हो जाएगी।
स्टूडेंट डेटा कलेक्शन इज एन इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एंड डेवलपमेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन कोलैबोरेशन विद न्यूपा एंड द बेसिक पर्पस ऑफ कलेक्शन ऑफ स्टूडेंट डेटा इज दैट वी वांट टू रिड्यूस द ओवर रिपोर्टिंग एनरोलमेंट और इफ देयर इज अ ड्यूअल और फेक एनरोलमेंट टू रिड्यूस दैट फेक और ड्यूअल एनरोलमेंट वी विल बी कलेक्टिंग द स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा फ्रॉम द ईयर 2016 एंड 17 Data collection of student-wise is in sync with Unified District Information System for Education, that is UDIS, which is already in place since 1994-95. And from the last 22 years, we all are involved in strengthening of Unified District Information System for Education. And as Professor Mehta has already told you that Unified District Information System for Education, in this particular scheme, we are having the enrollment. But presently we were having the aggregate enrollments. So due to some over reporting of enrollment or due to dual enrollment or fake enrollment, some figures were not matching in Unified District Information System for Education. Now by using, by collecting, by analyzing student wise data, we will be able to generate accurate and up to date student wise information and enrollment aggregates in Unified District Information System for Education.
The ideal place where the data entry should take place is a school. But unfortunately, majority of schools in our country, they still do not have computers. And if they have computers, there is no guarantee that they also have access to internet. Keeping this in the mind, we have made elaborate arrangements to ensure smooth data entry so far as student-wise data is concerned. Online application, offline application, semi-online application, stand-alone application, and bulk uploading through the Excel sheets have been made available to our users. They can use any one of these modes and sync the data or upload the data by themselves or just by going to the block resource center coordinator. Our block resource center coordinators will facilitate the data so provided by the schools in order to sync the same to the UDIS.
Professor Mehta has very correctly said that there are many modes and many levels where the student data can be fed into the system. ideal situation, as Professor Mehta has already told, ideal situation, ideal position from where the data entry can be done is a school level. That is the first hand information which can be collected and entered into the system. But for that, a school needs a computer, a manpower and internet, dedicated internet, if they want to do the data entry online. Still, we think that, as Mehta ji has already told, that there are many schools where either computer is not available, or if computer is available, internet is not available. In that case, we are having many modes using which the school itself can do the data entry. We are having a standalone utility. We are having a bulk upload utility. In a standalone utility, there will be an application, small application, which is to be installed on the computer. And then the headmaster or the headmistress can enter the data directly onto the system using that utility. Else, there is a Excel template file, that is bulk upload utility, Excel template file is there, in which the headmaster or headmistress or any class teacher or any respondent from the school can enter the data into the Excel, and then that Excel sheet can be uploaded onto the online database. This is ideal situation when we can enter the data, where we can enter the data from school level. But still, if the school does not have enough infrastructure like computer, manpower or internet facility, then also they have to fill the data capture format, and the data capture format is to be provided to the CRC coordinator. In a state, if at cluster level, if you are having the infrastructure like computer, manpower and internet, then from CRC level, cluster resource center level, you can enter the data onto the server directly online, or again you can use a independent utility or bulk upload method at the CRC level. Still, if you are not having the infrastructure at the CRC level, then the same method, either online, offline, semi-online, any method can be implemented at the block level. In most of the blocks of our country, already UDIS is implemented. And most of the blocks, the UDIS data entry is done using our UDIS school database module and other modules, other softwares. So in that module also, in that UDIS module also, we had given a provision where you can enter the student wise data. Still, if you don't have infrastructure, manpower and internet or computers or software at the block level, then the same can be implemented at the district level, where 100% districts, all the districts of India, are having UDIS software, manpower and computer. That means enough infrastructure is available at all the districts, where our MIS officials, SSA MIS officials and RMSA MIS officials, both are involved in data collection and data entry of UDIS data capture format. Similarly, at the district level also, you can enter the student-wise data capture, student-wise information. In small UTs like Puducherry, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu, Dadar and Nagar Haveli, in these smaller UTs, we are providing online facility. This online facility is not only for these smaller UTs, but this online utility is applicable for all the schools. If any school is interested in entering the student data online, our servers are available, our portal is available, a user ID and password will be provided to your CRC coordinator, to your block level, to your district level. All these user management and all the infrastructure from the national level is dedicated for student database management information system, which is in sync with UDIS. So you have to collect all this information, and you can enter the data as and when before 30th September or in the mid of October also, before printing the UDIS data capture format, this data is to be collected. And please remember that this is mandatory this year. Student wise collection of the data is mandatory and it is not optional for anybody.
To do this, all the districts have been provided 1 rupee per child for data entry under Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program. And now the Government of India, the Ministry of Human Resource Development, has also approved 1 rupee per child for RMSA schools.
Very truly said, sir. sometimes we are getting a call on toll free number 1800116200 that whether we have to collect the student wise information from secondary and higher secondary sections of the schools. Yes, but when we say yes, they say that we had not received any funds from RMSA, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan. For that, Professor Mehta has already specified that Ministry of Human Resource and Development, Government of India, RMSA, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan has already approved and they are in the process of dispersing the funds to secondary sections or RMSA schools or secondary sections of composite schools. So don't worry about the secondary and higher secondary sections. Student information from secondary and higher secondary sections are also to be collected.
So from which school the student data is to be collected? Is it possible to collect data of 25.9 crores students? So don't you think that capacity building is to be done at the district level for the implementation of SDMIS? Is there any alternative method or utility which can be used at the school or cluster level for collecting student-wise data? Do we have any user manual, document or video tutorial which I can refer while data collection and entry of students?
Yes, we can definitely use Excel sheets to collect the student-wise data, and then the Excel sheets can be uploaded to online national server in the student database.
अगर आपके स्कूल में कंप्यूटर नहीं है, इंटरनेट की व्यवस्था नहीं है, उस स्थिति में आपको एक्सेल शीट यूज करनी है, और अगर आप एक्सेल शीट यूज करेंगे तो उसमें आपके स्कूल में बच्चों की संख्या के हिसाब से कॉलम और रोज जनरेट करके दे दी जाएगी, और फिर उसको हम आप लोग या तो ब्लॉक लेवल तक ले जाएंगे जहां पर डेटा एंट्री की व्यवस्था की गई है, या ऑनलाइन हम सिंक करवा देंगे.
ड्यूरिंग फिलिंग द डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट इफ यू नीड एनी हेल्प you can call us on a toll free number that is 1800116200, or you can visit our website student.udice.in.
you can get the detailed information about student DCF or student data capture format at student.udice.in. in addition to this, you will also get videos available on filling up ऑफ स्टूडेंट डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट, और ये जो वीडियोस हैं हिंदी में भी उपलब्ध है और इंग्लिश में भी उपलब्ध है.
यस, यू शुड कंडक्ट ब्लॉक लेवल वर्कशॉप्स, डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल वर्कशॉप्स फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन हाउ टू फिल द डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट एंड हाउ टू कंप्यूटराइज द डेटा विच इज कलेक्टेड ऑन द स्टूडेंट डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट. द डेटा एंट्री, ऑनलाइन डेटा एंट्री इज टू बी डन ऑन द student.udice.in. And offline and hybrid mode data entry can be done at the block level, district level or cluster level using the UDICE software which you are using from the last so many years.
अभी थोड़े ही दिनों में हम लोग सभी 680 जिलों के लिए रीजनल वर्कशॉप आयोजित करने वाले हैं, और उसके तुरंत बाद इस वर्कशॉप, इन रीजनल वर्कशॉप के बाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पे ही इसी तरह की वर्कशॉप जहां पर ब्लॉक रिसोर्स सेंटर कोऑर्डिनेटर्स, सीआरसी कोऑर्डिनेटर्स, स्कूल के हेडमास्टर साहब, प्रिंसिपल, वो सब पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे, और हमें पूरी उम्मीद है कि किसी भी तरह का कोई शंका अगर होगी तो उसका समाधान जो ये जो वर्कशॉप होगी उसमें हो जाएगा.
नो, नेक्स्ट ईयर यू डोंट हैव टू कलेक्ट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. ओनली सम लिमिटेड इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी कलेक्टेड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हुज डेटा इज कलेक्टेड दिस ईयर. But next year, only all the variables, all the 35 variables will be collected for only those students who are either new entrants in any class or for the students of class 1 only.
भरे हुए फॉर्म्स को, स्कूल द्वारा भरे हुए फॉर्म्स को पहले क्लस्टर रिसोर्स सेंटर कोऑर्डिनेटर्स देखेंगे और इसकी डिटेल्ड इंफॉर्मेशन वो जांच लेंगे. उसके बाद में ब्लॉक स्तर पर यानी कि खंड स्तर पर एग्रीगेट इन्फॉर्मेशन, अगर जितने भी स्कूल का डेटा है उसका एग्रीगेट इन्फॉर्मेशन जांचेंगे ब्लॉक लेवल पे. इसी तरह डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पे भी द MIS कोऑर्डिनेटर वर्किंग एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल विल थोरली रिव्यू द इन्फॉर्मेशन विच ही हैज रिसीव्ड और सी हैज रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द ब्लॉक लेवल. जब आपके स्कूल की डेटा एंट्री हो जाएंगी उसके बाद कंप्लीट हो जाएगी तो आपको ऑनलाइन पोर्टल से भी प्रिंट आउट मिल जाएगा, आप उसको फिर वेरीफाई कर सकते हैं। अगर डेटा एंट्री आपने नहीं की है और दूसरी जगह पे हुई है तो आपको अपने स्कूल का स्टूडेंट वाइज इन सभी बिंदुओं के ऊपर ये जानकारी मिल जाएगी प्रिंटेड फॉर्म में, ताकि आप वापस उसको जांच लें और मिला लें। आपके पास में जो हार्ड कॉपी के ऊपर ये जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है देख लें कि डेटा एंट्री सही हुई है। 2016-17 में वी हैव गॉट टू पार्ट्स इन आवर डीसीएफ। एक पार्ट तो है जो ट्रेडिशनल यूडाइस का है और दूसरा इस बार जैसा आप सब जानते ही हैं स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट भी हमने जोड़ दिया है। अगर आपका स्कूल यूनिफाइड डाइस में नहीं जुड़ा है तो दो तरीके से आप यूडाइस कोड ले सकते हैं और फॉर्म भी भर सकते हैं। हमारी वेबसाइट www.dice.in से आप डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट को डाउन कर लें और उसके बाद में उसको भर के और जो आपका ब्लॉक है ब्लॉक लेवल के में MIS कोऑर्डिनेटर है उनके पास में ये फॉर्म जमा कर दें और जमा करते वक्त आपको यूडाइस कोड मिल जाएगा। उसके तुरंत बाद जो दूसरा फॉर्मेट अभी हमने आपको बताया स्टूडेंट डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट, उसकी जानकारियां हासिल करना आप प्रारंभ कर दें।
सर, फ्रॉम विच रिकॉर्ड और रजिस्टर आई कैन फाइंड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट स्टूडेंट्स रिलीजन सोशल कैटेगरी BPL एक्सेट्रा। सर, फ्रॉम विच रिकॉर्ड आई कैन फाइंड टोटल नंबर ऑफ डेज स्टूडेंट अटेंडेड स्कूल ड्यूरिंग प्रीवियस एकेडमिक ईयर if the student joined this school in this academic year only. Sir, what is the use of collecting email address and mobile number of parent or guardian, and can you guarantee that it will not be shared with any third person? Sir, what will happen if a student is not giving details of all the students in this school? Sir, can you please explain date of admission? Is it the date of admission in this school or in this class? Sir, is it mandatory to fill admission number? Sir, why do we need habitation or locality where the student lives? Sir, what is special training and to whom it is provided? Sir, will there be any student who got admission directly into any intermediate classes like 2nd, 3rd, 4th, etc.? Sir, what is trade or sector? And is it mandatory for all the students to fill? Sir, what is stream and is it mandatory for all the students to fill? Sir, after filling DCF, to whom I should submit the filled in DCF form? Sir, will I get a one page report or student profile like we are getting school report card? Sir, whether the DCF is to be filled in English only?
From the admission register, you will get the information about students, religion, social category, admission number, date of admission, and other basic parameters of a student. Total number of days the student attended will be available in the attendance register. But if a student has admitted in this school from any other school, so then you can refer his or her report card in which the total number of attended days is written. Otherwise, if still that information is not available, you can leave it blank. Date of admission of a student is that date you have to mention in the data capture format, the date when the student got admitted into the school. But if the student, for example, in many states, the student gets new admission after class 5th, when he completes class 5th and comes to the class 6th. Then if in the school there is a provision of giving a new admission to all those students who are completing the primary education cycle up to class 5 and getting admission into new class, class 6, then the date of admission will be the date of admission of that particular class. That means when he got admitted into class 6th. And same will be the admission number. The admission number might change when a student get admissions, when a student get admission from class 5 to class 6th, or when a student is getting a readmission in class 11th after clearing his class 10th. What is trade and sector? Trade and sector are the variables or component of a vocational education system. These variables, trade and sector, are applicable only for the students of class 9th to 12th, but only for the students who had opted for vocational education. So you have to specify the code of the course listed for the trade and sector for the students of class 9th and 10th. What is stream? Stream is applicable only for the students of class 11th and 12th, and there are streams coded as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and these streams are arts, science, commerce, vocational studies and other. So these streams, you have one stream out of these 5 you have to specify for the student of class 11th to 12th. Each and every student entered into the system. Yes, the student data capture format is to be filled in the English language only. You might get the data capture format in your state, in your regional language, but the contents, the values which you have to type, which you have to write on the data capture format should be in English only. Initially, the student data capture format is to be filled once in a year for UDIS, but once the data has been entered into the system, once the data is online, then you can update the data whenever there is a transaction in the school. If a student transfers from one school to another school, you can directly log into the web portal student.udis.in and you can update the data. So that means it will become a real-time system. Is it possible to fill the student data capture student data directly onto the computer without filling the student DCF? Yes, it is possible to fill the student data directly onto the computer or directly onto the portal, but it will be very difficult for you to consult multiple records from the school about one student and then fill the data directly online. It will take too much time, so it is better and it is recommended to fill the data capture format first, and then from the data capture format you should fill the data onto the computer or onto the student.udis.in online portal. Yes, you have to collect the data from each and every school, either it is a special school, formal school, unrecognized school, private school, unaided school, aided school or government school. Any kind of school, you have to collect the student-wise data. In the bigger schools, like having class 1 to 12 and multiple sections and large number of students, like 2000, 3000 or 4000 students in a school, there it is better to distribute the data capture format to the class teachers, because a class teacher might be having 40 to 50 students or 30-35 students in one class, and he or she will be definitely, they will be able to fill the data in time onto the data capture format, and parallelly all the data capture formats for each and every class, each and every section can be filled and can be, the task can be completed in time. Yes, it is better to retain a copy of the student DCF in the school, although the student DCF will remain within the school because this data capture format, once the data capture format is filled and the data entry is done from the school level in the online portal or in the offline utility also, then this data capture format is not to be shared with any other level, like this format is not to be given to the CRC level or BRC level. But in case the data entry is not taking place from the school level, then you have to give this data capture format, all the data capture formats for all the students to the CRC level or to the BRC level where the data entry is to be done. But in that case, retain a copy of the student data capture format in your school for reference. No, it is not recommended to outsource the data entry or data collection process for the student data capture format. It is also not recommended to give the data capture format to the parents to fill that. We should not ask the student's parent to fill the data about their student and then return to the school, respective school. Data capture format is to be filled by the school headmaster or the school class class teacher or the respondent nominated by the school headmaster. These data capture formats are not to be filled by the parents.
हमें किन विद्यालयों से स्टूडेंट डेटा कलेक्शन करना है? क्या सेकेंडरी और हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल से भी डेटा कलेक्ट करना है? स्टूडेंट की किस तरीके की जानकारी भरनी है? क्या आधार नंबर भरना अनिवार्य है? भरी इकट्ठी करने की जिम्मेवारी किसकी है? क्या अब यूडाइज नहीं भरा जाएगा? यूडाइज में डेट ऑफ रेफरेंस 30 सितंबर होती है, स्टूडेंट में क्या होगी? अगर किसी बच्चे का आधार नंबर नहीं है तो स्टूडेंट DCF में क्या भरेंगे? ERC कोऑर्डिनेटर की क्या भूमिका है? क्या ऑनलाइन सिस्टम इतने सारे यूजर्स को मैनेज कर पाएगा?
Who is responsible in the school to collect the student data? Sir, where will the data entry take place for student data? Whether we should do workshops at our levels, like district or block levels? Sir, do we require internet connection for entering the student data to the national server? Sir, what will happen if the student data is not provided by a school? I have an approval for only 60 students, whereas I have an enrollment of 100 students. Should I fill data of 100? If yes, whether any action would be taken against me?
Sir, क्या 25 करोड़ बच्चों की विस्तृत जानकारी भरना संभव है?
16-17 से हम लोग स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इकट्ठा कर रहे हैं। सभी विद्यालय जो यूडाई से जुड़ गए हैं या ऐसे विद्यालय, कुछ विद्यालय जो अभी भी जुड़ने बाकी हैं, चाहे वो रिकॉग्नाइज्ड हो या अनरिकॉग्नाइज्ड हो, चाहे वो फॉर्मल स्कूल हो या नॉन फॉर्मल स्कूल हो, जहां कहीं भी शिक्षा कक्षा 1 से 12 की दी जा रही है, उन सबको हमें इस कार्य में लगाना है और इन सभी विद्यालयों में स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा को इकट्ठा करना है।
स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इज टू बी कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम ऑल स्कूल्स ऑफ इंडिया। ऑल स्कूल्स मींस ऑल रिकॉग्नाइज्ड, अनरिकॉग्नाइज्ड, प्राइमरी, प्राइमरी विद अपर प्राइमरी, प्राइमरी विद अपर प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी, सेकेंडरी स्कूल्स ओनली और सेकेंडरी विद हायर सेकेंडरी, मदरसाज, मदरसाज रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एंड अनरिकॉग्नाइज्ड, whether the school is teaching only pre-primary to class 5th or from class 6 to class 12, all kind of schools are to be covered under this scheme, and most of the schools are already covered under Unified District Information System for Education, but now the student data is to be collected from all the schools of our country.
सभी secondary और higher secondary school से भी student wise data इकट्ठा करना है, और तो और अगर कक्षा 11 और 12 कॉलेज एजुकेशन का पार्ट है तो उन संस्थानों से भी हमें स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इकट्ठा करना है।
ऑफ कोर्स स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इज टू बी कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम सेकेंडरी एंड हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल्स आल्सो, वेदर द सेकेंडरी और हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल्स आर इंडिपेंडेंट स्कूल्स और दे आर पार्ट ऑफ अ कंपोजिट स्कूल। इफ अ स्कूल इज हैविंग क्लास 1 टू क्लास 12, देन ऑल्सो the student wise data is to be collected from class 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th, that means from the secondary and higher secondary sections of the school.
ki aise bindu isme rakhe jaye taki UDIS mein jo enrollment based tables hai, chahe wo school enrollment by category ho, enrollment by age and grade ho, ya enrollment by medium instruction ho, ya dusre bhi jaise CWSN ka data hai, nature of disability hai, या इंसेंटिव है प्राइमरी लेवल पे या अपर प्राइमरी लेवल पे, इस तरह के सारे आंकड़े जो स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा हम इकट्ठा करने जा रहे हैं उससे अगर आ जाए तो हमारी डेटा की गुणवत्ता काफी बढ़ जाएगी।
सही कहा सर आपने। आप अगर देखेंगे तो हमारे प्रपत्र में भी हमने आधार नंबर, स्टूडेंट की डेट ऑफ बर्थ, उसका डेट ऑफ एडमिशन, उसका रिलीजन, सोशल कैटेगरी, बच्चा क्या विकलांग है, अगर विकलांग है तो उसमें विकलांगता का प्रकार, बच्चे को आयरन की टैबलेट, बच्चे को आयरन टैबलेट, विटामिन टैबलेट, इस तरह की सुविधाएं दी गई हैं कि नहीं, बच्चे को और किस तरह की सुविधाएं, किस तरह की फैसिलिटीज प्रदान की जा रही हैं विद्यालय में, बच्चा विद्यालय में कितने दिन उपस्थित रहा, इस तरह की सारी जानकारियां हम प्रपत्र में रख रहे हैं। प्रपत्र में इन सब जानकारियों को रखने से, स्टूडेंट वाइज इंफॉर्मेशन लेने से हमें फायदा ही होगा कि हम UDIS रिलेटेड जितनी भी हमारी एनरोलमेंट टेबल्स हैं वो सब तो हमारी जनरेट हो ही जाएंगी। इसके अलावा जो UDIS में एनरोलमेंट रिलेटेड जो इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं भी अवेलेबल है वो भी अब हम इसमें क्रॉस सेक्शनल इंफॉर्मेशन, स्टूडेंट की क्रॉस सेक्शनल इंफॉर्मेशन अब हम इस प्रपत्र के जरिए इकट्ठी कर पाएंगे।
हमें पूरी उम्मीद है कि स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा इकट्ठा करने से हमारी यूटाइज की डेटा की गुणवत्ता, विशेष रूप से नामांकन की गुणवत्ता या एनरोलमेंट की क्वालिटी और बेहतर होने की पूरी पूरी उम्मीद है।
जरूर सर। फॉर दिस ईयर इट इज नॉट मैंडेटरी टू कलेक्ट द आधार नंबर ऑफ द स्टूडेंट, बट इफ अ स्टूडेंट इज हैविंग अ आधार नंबर, व्हाई डोंट वी प्रोवाइड इट? It is beneficial to provide the Aadhaar number of a student. If you provide the Aadhaar number of each and every student who is having the Aadhaar number, then most of the information will be automatically validated by the system, by the student database management system. Aadhaar number will be automatically validated with the UIDAI national database, and the correct information will be generated in the UDIS system along with the student database management information system. So don't think that this year Aadhaar is optional, but from next year it may be mandatory, but presently this year Aadhaar is not mandatory, but if it is available, then kindly provide correct Aadhaar number of the student.
UDIS band nahi hoga. UDIS jaisa abhi chalta aaya hai, shuruaat ke varshon mein aisa hi chalta rahega. Jab hum student wise data puri tarah se ikattha kar lenge और यूडाइस की सभी एनरोलमेंट की टेबल्स इससे जनरेट कर देंगे, तब धीरे धीरे हम यूडाइस में से एनरोलमेंट की एग्रीगेट टेबल्स को हटा देंगे। लेकिन अभी शुरुआत के वर्षों में यूडाइस जैसा चलता आया है वैसा ही चलेगा, लेकिन इसमें स्टूडेंट वाइज डेटा भी जोड़ दिया गया है।
यूडाइस इज नॉट गोइंग टू स्टॉप नाउ. By the student data capture format or the inclusion of student database management information system, UDIS is now more strengthened in principle. Why? Because the student data capture format or the student information will only generate the enrollment related information of UDIS. Rest of the information in UDIS, like school information, MDM information, RTE information or teachers information, that will remain as it is for the current year 2016-17 or for the initial years like 1 or 2 years next year also. Until and unless the student data captures, student information is collected completely, till then UDIS will remain as it is. But after that also UDIS is not going to stop. After the complete implementation of student database into the UDIS, only the enrollment aggregates will be removed from UDIS. Rest of the UDIS format will remain as it is, or some minor modifications will be there, but UDIS will not stop.
The date of reference of UDIS, as we all know, is 30th September. That will remain as it is, but we should initiate student wise data collection, and to ensure that the same is finished just before printing the data capture format from the UDIS software. So when we print the data capture format, the enrollment statistics and all other statistics will remain as on 30th September of the current year, that is 2016. So there is no change in the date of reference, it will remain the same. But we have to ensure that the student wise data collection is finished before printing of the data capture format from the UDIS software.
You are correct. Date of reference for data collection under UDIS is 30th September. But don't wait for 30th September to collect the student wise data. Just start the student wise data collection from right now, from today itself, so that the data entry and the data collection of the student wise data completes before printing of UDIS data capture format. That is, it is very good if you can complete the data collection and data entry of student wise data before printing the UDIS data capture format in 30th September. What will be the benefit is that if the data capture format, if the student wise data is collected and entered into the system before printing of UDIS data capture format as on 30th September, then you can print the data capture format along with the enrollment aggregates in UDIS. these enrollment aggregates will be generated from student wise database, and then this data capture format will be sent to school, as we are sending in the earlier years also. So the data capture format will be validated by the school headmaster. In that process, the enrollment collected before 30th September will be verified by the headmaster as of 30th September. Hence, the date of reference of data collection under UDAS will remain as 30th September, but the student data collection can start now. We have to start it. आपने सही कहा, UDAS में डेटा कलेक्शन की डेट ऑफ रेफरेंस जो तिथि है वो 30 सितंबर है, मतलब हम एज ऑफ 30 सितंबर को जो डेटा होता है विद्यालय में हम वही कलेक्ट करते हैं, परंतु विद्यार्थी या छात्र छात्रावार जो आंकड़ा आपको कलेक्ट करना है, जो आपको स्टूडेंट वाइज इंफॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करनी है, उसके लिए आप 30 सितंबर का इंतजार मत कीजिए, आप अभी से आज से ही ये इंफॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करना शुरू कर दीजिए, क्योंकि अगर 30 सितंबर से पहले या UDAS डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट प्रिंट करने से पहले अगर आप छात्र छात्रावार इंफॉर्मेशन जो आपको स्टूडेंट इंफॉर्मेशन जो आपको कलेक्ट करनी है अगर आप कलेक्ट करके एंट्री नहीं करवा लेते हैं तो UDAS डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट में एनरोलमेंट की जो प्रिंटिंग होगी, एनरोलमेंट एग्रीगेट की जो टेबल्स प्रिंट होगी वो स्टूडेंट डेटाबेस से ही प्रिंट होगी, और जो स्टूडेंट डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट के बाद जो आपने एंट्री कराई उसके थ्रू जो एनरोलमेंट एग्रीगेट जनरेट होगी वही एनरोलमेंट एग्रीगेट UDAS डेटा कैप्चर फॉर्मेट में प्रिंट होके जाएगी, और उस प्रपत्र को, आंकड़ा संग्रह प्रपत्र जो आपका UDAS का होगा, उसको प्रधानाध्यापक या प्रधानाध्यापिकाएं उसको प्रमाणित करेंगी, उसको वेरीफाई करेंगी, तो आपकी इंफॉर्मेशन एज ऑफ 30th सितंबर ही रहेगी, लेकिन आपके स्टूडेंट वाइज इंफॉर्मेशन आप अभी से कलेक्ट करना शुरू कर दीजिए। Thank you.